Let's go to breaking news unfolding overseas. Protesters swarming the streets of Paris after a man killed at least three people and injured four in a shooting. The gunman fired several shots at a Kurdish cultural centre packed with small shops and cafes in the central part of the city, and these pictures are just into our newsroom. Rioters clashing with police, lighting fires and damaging cars. It is confronting. CNN reporter Jim Biederman is in Paris for us. Jim, are the protests under control?
Yes, at this point I would say so, Alison. In fact, the things have quieted down a bit, although there are still some crowds out there as the Kurds try to talk about their plight here in Paris, the same kind of plight, the same kind of persecution that they feel sometimes in the Middle East. Basically, this all began with the shootings at around noon local time, when three people were killed, another three or four people were injured, including one that is in critical condition, could very well pass away. So the police came out to investigate the murders, and they caught a suspect, a 69-year-old Frenchman, who got out of jail only 11 days ago. He was being held preventively for a racially motivated attack a year ago. At almost the same time last year, he was held in jail for the last year, and 11 days ago he was released, and today the police say, anyway, that he committed the murders. The crowds gathered after the police tried to cordon off the crime scene, and this is a neighborhood that's racially mixed. It has been tense in the past, and as a consequence, when the police showed up, there was a little bit of arguing back and forth, and then eventually people started throwing things at the police, calling them murderers and whatnot. Then the crowd, the situation basically degenerated from there. They started burning garbage cans and things like that in the streets. The police moved in, the firemen moved in. The police had to protect the firemen because the demonstrators were throwing things at the firemen. So it eventually calmed down, but after a good bit of time and after some pretty violent scenes.
Okay, Jim, Alison? We'll leave it there. Thank you very much. Welcome back to Weekend Today. Thank you for your company. We're coming up on 8 a.m. A developing situation in Paris this morning where protesters have swarmed the streets after a man killed three people. The gunman fired multiple shots on a Kurdish cultural centre. Let's bring in today's talkers, Nova's Michelle Stevenson and Queensland Senator Matt Canavan. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
Matt, this alleged shooter was apparently known to police. Only a year ago, he attacked migrant tents, and yet he was out on the streets. Surely this isn't good enough.
Well, that will be the question that's going to be asked in the next few days. Why was this person on the loose? As you say, he was alleged to have committed that act with a sabre, I believe, on a migrant camp just a year ago. Apparently he was still up on charges and presumably was out on bail, but being charged with such a serious offence, you've got to wonder why or how that was allowed to happen. Obviously there's been an immediate reaction of anger on the streets of Paris, so hopefully that situation can get under control. And also, of course, I'd like to express my sympathy for the Kurdish community. They are people that have been persecuted throughout history, and this is a particularly cruel and tragic incident to afflict them in a country they thought they had refuge in.
Absolutely. And Michelle, as Matt mentioned, there are now violent clashes in central Paris. It's very confronting to be seeing. Do you think that will deter people from travelling there?
I mean, I think it's probably too late to cancel any plans. I don't think it will deter people from travelling there. We've seen this with Paris for a few years now. It seems to be a hotbed of, you know, kind of terrorism and a lot of acts of violence. I don't know what the answer is for the Parisians, but I think people won't stop travelling there. I just think you just need to have some caution maybe about what you're doing and where you're going in around Paris, because I know there are pockets of it that can be quite violent.
All right, let's look at some other news closer to home now. And the number of Sydney children moving away from the mainstream schooling system is increasing, with a rising cohort of deliberate homeschoolers spiking by 170% in New South Wales. Michelle, I thought parents hated homeschooling during the pandemic, but applications are flooding in for next year.
Yeah.
Is it the way of the future?
I know, I was shaking my head. I was like, who are these people? This is crazy. Anyone who had to do this during the pandemic really struggled. I know I did. Look, I guess kids got a taste for it and they enjoyed it. The one thing I did understand out of homeschooling was like how many hours a day of actual schooling they need. It's not as much as you actually think. So they spend a lot of time, you know, going to classes and spending time with their friends. But I think my only concern would be how much interaction are they having with their peers, and are they missing out on those kind of things that I think are quite of integral to like growing up.
Matt, do you think homeschooling can rival traditional schools?
Well, look, I think for the reasons given, I doubt it, because it's just such a commitment from individual parents, and I've got a great respect for those parents who take it on because it's a huge challenge. I actually did enjoy, I loved it during lockdown. I loved homeschooling the kids, but it just takes so much time and it shows what great work our teachers do. But families that can have the time and can afford to do it, I think it's a great thing to spend time with your kids. I get the concern about interaction with peers, but I always found it strange that you go to school in this sort of industrial environment. You're only friends with people from 1 year, the 1 year you were born in, and kids that were 1 year older and 1 year younger than you were sort of aliens, and that seemed a bit strange too. So school's not necessarily a natural environment either, but good on those parents who have this commitment to the kids.
That's brave.
Yeah.
And finally, Princess Mary has touched down in Hobart, the Royal, giving us a snapshot of her Christmas celebrations, sharing this beautiful photo of her family spending the holidays together. She captioned the snap, "Merry Christmas from down under. Here it is neither frostbite nor just trees, but summer and warm weather." Merry Christmas to both of you. Just quickly, what's on the agenda for your Chrissy, Matt?
Shops are still open today, aren't they? I think they are. I've got to finish that off first.
Get busy.
And then we'll probably go to Mass tonight. It is the birth of Jesus. And then, yeah, tomorrow the kids will, we presents. That's what it'll be about.
And Michelle?
Yeah, I'm heading straight to the shops from here to get some presents. I'm terrible. And then tomorrow, you know, I'm live in Bondi. So what am I going to do? I'm going to go to the beach.
Enjoy.
Heading to the beach.
Merry Christmas to both of you. Thank you for taking time out of your Christmas Eve.
Well, mourners in Paris are coming together for a candlelit vigil at the scene of a deadly shooting. Protesters earlier swarmed the streets of Paris after a man killed three people and injured four others. The 69-year-old Frenchman fired multiple shots on a Kurdish cultural centre and had just been released from jail. Riot police returning with tear gas as protesters lit fires and threw rubbish bins. French President Emmanuel Macron tweeting thoughts to the victims, to the people who are struggling, to their families and loved ones.